blessings upon blessings. This is J-Unity from Richmond, VA. Please stay tuned for season 7 of
Let's Talk to the Lord,
gospel radio talk show, created and hosted by Apostle John E. Ross. And we are J-U.
Trying to do what's right, but end up
doing. Lord, please give me another chance.
Make me, Lord, I want you to
real music, real interviews, real information. That's why we call it Real Gospel with the X-Man.
You're a radio minister of music, and you know what? We all need the Lord to give us another chance. Or at least we've asked Him to give us another chance. This is Apostle John E. Ross. Lord, give me another chance. This is Real Gospel.
Satan is trying to take a hold of my life. I keep on fighting, and it seems I'm losing the fight. But Lord, I'm silly from my heart. I think it's time for a brand new start. So, oh Lord, give me another chance. Now come on and help me sing it right now.
This from my heart.
I
promise I won't sin no more.
I won't sin no more.
Yeah. Creating me a pure heart. Ever knew a great spirit in me? Have I worked in my heart?
Sin against thee.
Oh Lord, oh Lord, oh Lord, oh Lord. I really made up my mind.
stage. Come on, let's go. Woo!
This from my heart.
From my heart.
I won't sin.
I won't sin no more.
Oh, Lord, mold me.
Make me.
Lord, I want you to have
mine own way.
Come on, let's do it again.
Gospel is the place where God gets the glory and artists tell their stories. I'm honored to have this anointed man of God on the program with me right now. I'm talking about the one and only Apostle John E. Ross. Thank you so very much for joining us on Real Gospel, sir.
Man, it is a blessing to be here with you and your audience on this day.
Yes. And right off the bat, I just want you to know that I am definitely loving the song, Lord, Give Me Another Chance, because, you know, every time I've done wrong in my life, that's exactly what I say to the Lord. Lord, give me one more chance. So
yeah.
You hit it out of the park with that one. But before we get into your music, for those individuals who just found Jesus Christ as their personal Lord and Savior on yesterday, let's speak to them for a moment and just introduce you to them. Tell them a little bit about, you know, how you grew up, where you're from, and how you first fell in love with Jesus.
Hey, man. Well, I am from the Quad City area, the Davenport, Rock Island, Moline, East Moline, Bettendorf. They're an area where Illinois is on one side, Iowa's on one side, and you cross the bridge, and there's a whole lot of towns right there together, but in two different states. So they call it the Quad City. So that's where I began my walk with God. I was minister of music for about 13, 14 years. I began training and directing choir around the age of 23, and the Lord progressed me to kind of move up in the Kojic faith, and ended up being a assistant to the Professor Ira Stevenson within the Churches of God in Christ. I was assistant to the teen choir, and I did that for several years. And man, the trials of life hit me and knocked me off my feet. It made me question my faith in God, and so I backslid for a while, to make a long story short. But on July the 12th, 2012, I remember that day, and I remember it well, because the Holy Spirit showed up at work when I didn't even expect it. And the next thing I know, I was repenting and giving my life back to God, but this time through Jesus Christ, and was found out through the rebirthing process that the reason why I fell away the first time was because I wasn't rooted and grounded in Christ. So we began again. Lord, give me another chance. And the Lord gave me another chance to begin again, but this time more in the right way. And as that began to progress, the Lord brought me into starting a radio ministry called Let's Talk to the Lord Gospel Radio Talk Show. And through my obedience of saying yes to the talk show, and the Lord began to grow that ministry, it brought me into purpose, and it brought me to the place where I could re-record this song again. And we just thank God for Brother Sean Scales, Tamara Lloyd, and Minor Third Productions, who put the production together. And that is what brought me to you, Brother X-Man.
That's an excellent testimony. And I do know Sean Scales. He's been, Sean D. Scales has been on this program before for his music. A great guy. Matter of fact, he came by the studios. So shouts out to Sean D. Scales. Listen, you said something earlier about being visited by the Holy Spirit. Let's go backward for a second, because I feel as though the Lord wants you to unpack that just a little bit for people who understand what your experience means. I know I do. I had a similar experience. But for those who may not understand what that meant, how you were visited by the Holy Spirit at work, can you just talk just briefly about what that experience was like and what you went through?
Yes, I was at work. I had just began, I had came through a traumatic situation that had just came, that just happened at that time. I was involved in a fatal car crash. I was not at fault, but there was a fatality that was involved in that situation. And so around this time, you know, I began to again question my faith in God. I was backslidden, but was kind of wondering, like, Lord, okay, Lord, now this is adding to what has already previously happened to me. Why is this happening to me? What is wrong? And so anyway, I just happened to be online on Facebook, and I met an artist by the name of Anita Wilson. She was just releasing Worship Soul at that time.
Yes.
And I began to reach out to her, and she said that she had a project coming out called Worship Soul. And I said, okay, let me pick this project up. And so I picked it up. It arrived. I took it to work with me that day, got to work. And because of this matter that was already on my heart, you know, I began to kind of read my Bible again. And so I thought, well, I'm going to put in this tape. I read my scriptures that day. I'm going to put in this tape. And the matter was on my mind and heart. And I said, well, Lord, I'm going to put in this tape and see what kind of music Anita Wilson has. Well, Speechless came on. And then when Speechless came on, it was like a jackhammer. It was just like, you know how you break up cement? The Holy Spirit just began like a jackhammer, breaking up my stony heart. And I don't know, it was just like a portal, and the Spirit opened up, and there was God, and there he was, and I didn't expect to see him, and especially in that way. And man, the tears started flowing, and truly that song, you know, when I was telling the Lord that I love him, and you know the words to that song, it really expresses how you feel about God, and my heart was just feeling that about God, even though I was going through that traumatic experience again. And so I turned the tape off. I said, wait a minute, let me stop, because I'm at work. I can't be shouting at work. I said, this came to happen at work. And I turned it off, man. I went and did a couple rounds, came back to my station, put on the rest of that CD. And by the time we got down to those last few songs, the worship songs, More of You, and man, I just repented and just gave my life back to the Lord. And when I left work that day, I was on a new journey with God.
There it is. That just helps so many people, so many people. And I appreciate that testimony. I really do. And, you know, that, but to sort of leapfrog over time, that from that moment in your life to becoming an apostle is a huge, huge deal. And I guess we'll talk about that another time. But right now, your music career, when did you decide that it was time for you to record music like this? And talk to us about this project.
Well, God's timing is what decided that, because I did not know that this was on the schedule. I was working on another song that I was trying to get prepared to release, and I was just walking in purpose and obedience. I was recording the Let's Talk to the Lord gospel radio talk show, In obedience, I happened to be in a magazine called Music Lovers Magazine, and I was featured on the cover, and it was like my very first major magazine that featured my ministry on the cover. So I was really excited about that, and I was reading through the magazine, and the Lord brought me to Tamara Lloyd, and reached out to her, invited her onto the podcast. We recorded the podcast. During the podcast, she talked about her business that she does in revamping your songs. If you have a song that you need a background or instrumental, she will recreate those backgrounds and instrumentals for you. And so by the time the podcast was over, the Lord told me to reach out to her. So I reached out to her again, and I said, tell me more about your business. How does it work? She explained it to me, and I said, well, I got this song called Lord Give Me Another Chance that the Lord wants me to send your way for some reason. So I sent it to her. She listened to it. She said, oh, yes, we can do this. And we negotiated. She said, do you know Sean Scales? And I said, yes, I've heard of Sean. I met him in Atlanta at the Spin Awards, but I don't know him personally. She said, well, hold on a second. He would be perfect for this song. So she put me on hold, reached out to him. He was available. He said yes. She said, all right, it's a done deal. And within 1 month later, what you just heard is what the Lord anointed her to do.
Wow. That is simply that. Yeah, you are absolutely right about that. God's timing. And
yeah.
This project, because I'm loving the song, Lord, Give Me Another Chance. And it's incredible how it's come together. What more can we expect from the Apostle John E. Ross?
Well, man, maybe that song that I was working on prior to Awesome God, maybe we can get back on track again, or maybe God will offer me a good time to release it. But we're going to work on releasing more music that the Lord has given me. We're going to continue with Let's Talk to the Lord Gospel Radio Talk Show and continue in radio ministry. And just basically, man, I just want to do the will of God. I just want to walk in obedience to His will, do it the way that He says to do it, in the timing that He says to do it. And I just believe that whatever His will is, His holy and perfect will is, that He has for me, I'm going to walk into that purpose and continue my journey until He calls me home.
So your radio show, what's it like? What are some of the topics of discussion that you have on there?
On Let's Talk to the Lord, it's a show that God gave me, and He gave me specific instructions with the show. He said, as you invite your guest on to the podcast, allow them to pick your topic. And as they pick your topic, I want you and your guest and you both to go to my word and release to the kingdom, the listening audience, what my word says about that particular topic. And from that, you are talking to me, you are talking to the Lord. And so that's what we do. I interview within the fivefold ministry, of course, but
yes.
Then we also interview movies, playwrights, authors as well, and we go to the Word of God. Sometimes we'll do it in a ministry way, sometimes we'll do it in an interview way, but we dig into the Word. It's very Bible-based, and we release that Word on that topic to our guests. And then we end with some good gospel music. If it's an artist, we release their music that they are featuring. If they are not an artist, then what we do is we just go to the Lord and say, Lord, I need a good song that will complement what we are talking about so that we can leave a complete thought for the body of Christ that hopefully will help them grow and give them some good spiritual nuggets and some good direction from the podcast.
Amen to that. And one thing about that kind of format, the way God has you all structured that show, you have to know the word to pull that off, sir. You got
Amen.
To know the word. And maybe some Google, and maybe a little Google if you can pull it off for expediency purposes. That's all.
Yeah.
Yes. So listen, sir, it's been a pleasure and an honor having you on the program. And for the listeners who want to find out more information about you, where they can find more information about Lord Give Me Another Chance, and more information about your radio show, how can they find you?
Yes. Lord, Give Me Another Chance is available now in all digital platforms. So go to Amazon or over to Apple Music, whatever your music store is, it is there. My personal website is letstalktothelordradio.international. If you go there, you'll find the radio station. And if you're interested in hearing episodes from Let's Talk to the Lord, please go over to speaker.com, put in Let's Talk to the Lord, put in that apostrophe S, Let's Talk to the Lord, hit enter. Every episode from the last five seasons are there. We're also on iHeartRadio and Spotify. And if you're interested in being a guest on the podcast, the Lord is leading you my direction, please email me at letstalktothelord@yahoo.com.
There it is, the one and only, my friend, Apostle John E. Ross. Thank you so very much for joining us on Real Gospel, sir.
Amen.
You're listening to Real Gospel with the X-Men. And the Real Flashback Song of the Hour is on the way.